My name is Edith Otto. I was born in Napa, California, December the 4th, 1919. As you know, I'm almost 89 now. I've always been voting Republican. However, this time I chose to go Democratic. Actually, I just vote the way I want to. I've always been that way. Now, this election means a great deal to me because it'll probably be my last. And I want very much to see if we can get a young man who is very progressive, I think, in his thoughts, and I hope he can do what he aims to do with the cooperation of the citizens of the United States. We all must work together to help him. And whatever you can do will be a step forward. And let us not try any bigotry of any kind, because actually, as a citizen, it doesn't matter. We're all the same. I'm going to vote for Barack Obama and his running mate, Biden, because I feel that they will offer us the most as far as opportunities go, and hopefully open up some fields that younger graduates will be seeking jobs for. We cannot stay as we are. Everything must progress, and I'm hoping that with all of this, we can all become a united and really forceful nation and keep it that way. It wasn't whether I was just happened to think I should be a registered Republican, and that's how I thought I could vote, but I honestly feel very independent and vote for whomever I feel is the best candidate. Because Obama comes right out and speaks like he's speaking to you and trying to relay what he feels is the right way to go. And I believe he's had a lot of influence on all of us as voters to think, if we go with him, maybe with the United States and the government and everybody, all of us will cooperate and help him to make this a better world. I do. I think that he's got the enthusiasm, you know, that a lot of us, we just sort of go along, you know, follow the crowd. And you have to have your own standards too. And I think this is where we're lacking. Or maybe it's just me. As we get older, we don't think of being more aggressive anymore. I've stopped being aggressive and thinking I could change the world or something, because you're just one little old person sitting here and thinking, what can I do? I wish I could do more, but I can't. We need him. We need a young man. See, old people are like me. We just sort of sit back and listen, and I don't think they get things done. See, they don't, because they're satisfied with the way they're living, because their life has come, and they're almost ready to say, well, I've lived my life, I don't have to improve in anything, I'm satisfied. Whereas the younger man, like Obama, he says, hey, let's try to do this so we can all share in something good that'll make us all go forward. We all want to do that, but if you're my age, you say, no, it's got you do it. That's the truth. See, we're satisfied because I figure I don't have that kind of energy anymore that others have. Yeah, I think that that young man, though, he's come out and look at him. He's not outspoken, I don't think, because he's trying to improve things for every one of us, young and old. And you have to remember, if you have children just getting into that voting age, just think, they'll be listening to him, not me. because they'll say, oh, he's got the idea. He's able to present this so that I understand why I want to vote for certain things. And I think Obama will do it. I do. We need that young man and his enthusiasm to get things done differently. Because we've all been sitting here just year after year, just accepting things as they go. There's been nothing that drastic. Think about it. In Barack Obama, we will, I'm sure, make a change that everybody will live to enjoy. I don't know what else we can do. We must find a place for everyone who can work to at least, shall we say, be a part of the improvements that the world will be coming to thanks to Barack Obama. I think he'll help us. I really do. Okay? And yes, we can. Everybody help. Okay? Not just one person. Everyone must help. And let's get Barack Obama in. That's the best thing I think we can do. Because no more of the Bush and McCain looks like too old. You know. Come on, Barack. And if you disappoint me, I'll come and kick your butt.